Three mighty rivers converge. Welcome to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, home of the Pittsburgh Steelers. Today they line up against the Tennessee Titans. Nick Enberg here, and with me as always is Dan Fouts. What's the key to victory for Pittsburgh, Dan?
The Steelers would like nothing better than to throw early and often in this one, Dick. That's their bread and butter.
Thanks, Dan. And the third man in the booth is Ian Eagle. What's the key for Tennessee in this one, Ian?
Dick, they're going to let their defense loose early in the first quarter. When that tough D runs wild, they smell blood and they flat out attack.
Nedney kicks this one off. Touchback. They'll start from the 20-yard line.
Come out to the 20-yard line.
Mannix back to throw. He finds his man. And he's tackled after the first down pickup. It's now first and 10. Kreider trying it outside. He's across the 45. And he manages about two on that run. Maddox drops to throw. Incomplete. That pass intended for the wide receiver.
The defender got in his hip pocket on the snap and never left. Great coverage.
Yeah, that's just a sign of great athleticism. Able to cover him all over the field. It's now third and 7. Maddox takes his time. Interception.
You know, the quarterback knows that was his fault, Dick. You can only tempt fate so often before it catches up to you.
On the interception return.
It's now first and 10. Bennett pulls it in. And that completion will get them a first down. McNair going to the air. Incomplete on the long pass.
The intended receiver.
Now we have second and 10. McNair back to pass. Incomplete pass to the wide receiver.
Dick, they're going to have to test this DB more vertically. He was sitting all over that route.
Right.
McNair.
Tries to buy a little time. Incomplete. The quarterback in whiteout can't connect. It's now 4th and 10. Comella crashes straight ahead. Pittsburgh takes over on downs. It's now 1st and 10. Zero way to the outside. Run good for 2 yards.
That was a well-designed play. They just couldn't get a hat on everybody to spring them.
Yeah, sometimes the defense just gets behind the blockers and there's nothing an offense can do. Maddox looks downfield on 2nd down. He finds his mark. It's now 1st and 10.
Hot, hot. Hot, hot. Hot.
Zero way, trying it outside. Williams stops him. Nice tackle.
Hey, it wasn't spectacular, but those offensive coaches will take every single yard they can get. Decent job.
You're right, Dan, but I'm sure they'd like a little more out of the running game if they can get it. Keep it on the ground. And that one goes for about 4 yards.
The line did a good job of springing the running back there. With a hole that big, he couldn't help but make good yardage.
Yeah, Dan, I think the guy selling hot dogs could have made it through that hole. Zero way deep in the backfield.
Hot, hot.
Intercepted. He uses the straight arm.
The quarterback threw that thing up for grabs, and the defender comes away with a huge play.
No gain on the interception return.
It's now 1st and 10. Eddie George to the outside. Number 27 isn't getting up. This could be serious.
It looked like that play had a chance to break, but the defense swarmed him after only a couple.
In this game, you have to move quickly or you're just not going to be successful. Comella pulls forward. And that one goes for about 8 yards.
That's a defensive back's worst nightmare. The back flying down the field with a full head of steam, and you're the only one there to make a play.
Yeah, Dan, but at least he made the tackle. You have to give him that. It's now 1st and 10. McNair with nothing but. And the quarterback can't get away. Sack. Thank you.
Now we have second and 12. McNair back to throw. And the pass to the wideout falls incomplete. It's now third and 12. McNair looking downfield. He makes a great throw.
McNair did a nice job on that play. He didn't force it. He just waited for his man to come open and then hit him.
Yeah, and a first down is the result. Well done. McNair drops to throw on first. The long pass attempt falls incomplete.
The intended receiver.
McNair looks to pass on second down. Oh, the long ball doesn't work this time. The Titans come set. It's the seventh play of this drive. McNair back to throw on third down. Pass complete. And he was brought down, but he made the first down. Now we have first and 10. McNair drops to throw. Incomplete between the hashes.
The receiver's got to do a better job there. The defender was never threatened deep, and he was all over it.
You're right, Dan. The defender never had to turn his hips. Good coverage. Poor route.
McNair back to pass. Wycheck with the reception. And the completion will get them the first.
The pass completion.
Yeah, that's right, man.
McNair lines up for the 10th play of this drive. They go with the ground game. And that'll be a pickup of 6.
A key third down pass a few plays ago was huge. We'll see if they can use it as a springboard into the end zone here.
Yeah, those are the kind of plays that can make the difference in a game.
McNair checks the defense on second down. Comella, touchdown, Titans.
The offensive line did a nice job occupying the front seven, and the running back did the rest. Great run.
Yeah, when the front seven are engaged like that, the running back only has to worry about the secondary.
Nedney sets up for the extra point try. He knocks it through.
The point after is good.
Bedney kicks it off. The kick is sailing toward the end zone. They'll put it in play at the 20. Maddox reads the defense on first down. Zerway trying it outside. Past the 20. And that one goes for about 6 yards.
Zerway gets yardage, but the real story in that play was the men up front. They absolutely hammered the front seven of the defense.
Yeah, it looked like the defense was on roller skates there.
Zerway ready for the carry.
Hot, hot. Hot, hot.
They keep it on the ground. And that'll be enough for the first.
On the tackle.
We're too good, man.
Maddox checks out the defensive alignment on first down.
Hot, hot, hot.
He's back to throw. He wants a long one. Complete. And that'll be enough for the first. Now we have first and 10. Maddox, back to throw. Finds a hole in the middle of the defense. Williams stops him cold.
Brenner bailed his quarterback out on that play, snaring the ball before the defender could make a break on it.
Now we have first and 10.
Hot. Hot, hot. Hot, hot.
Zerway to the outside. He crosses the 35, and he stopped after just a few yards. That'll bring up second down. The catch. 22 yards on the pass. They go with the ground game. Zerway picks up some good yardage.
A field goal would be a moral victory for the defense in this situation. We'll see if they can come up with a stop.
Zerway is on the field.
Hot, hot.
Maddox flushed from the pocket, and he's taken down after a couple of yards. That'll bring up third and just a few. Now third and four. At the end of the first, it's the Titans. 7, the Steelers. 0. zero away,
makes the grab.
And he's tackled at the three. That'll bring up fourth and short.
The receiver needs to show more field awareness there. He broke off his route short of the first down marker, and fourth down as a result.
Yeah, but it was pretty good defense too, Dan. You can't fault the receiver completely. The kick is on its way. It's up and through the post. Good. Number three kicks it off. Touchback. They'll start from the 20-yard line.
Come out to the 20-yard line.
It's now first and 10. McNair releases. Soft hands, good completion.
Boy, the receiver demonstrated some amazing concentration on that play, fighting off the defender to make the tough catch in traffic.
You're right, Dan. I can't believe he was able to focus on the ball long enough to make that catch. McNair steps under center for this second down play. Comella trying it outside. And that one goes for about 7 yards.
On the carry.
Now we have first and 10. They keep it on the ground. And he's tackled at the 38. That'll bring up second and short.
Wow, I could have run through that hole. The offensive line just gashed the defense.
Yeah, that's the kind of hole that running backs dream about. Great blocking. Go with the ground game. Past the 45. Bell makes the hit.
The defense has got to be more stout up the middle, Ian. The offensive line is moving their interior people at will.
I think it's just a case of physically overwhelming them, Dan. The defense just looks helpless out there.
It's now first and 10. They keep it on the ground. He drops his shoulder. 20. He could score. Touchdown.
Comella accelerated as soon as he received the handoff, and before the defense knew what was happening, he was standing in the end zone.
Nedney readies for the point after. And the extra point is good. The Titans with an even bigger lead now because of that touchdown. Nedney kicks this one off. The kick is long, and the return man picks it up around the goal line. Past the 20. 22 yards on the return.
With the kick return.
Zerway gets the carry. And he's taken down, but after he gets the first. They go with the ground game. He could go all the way. Shoulders takes him down.
So far, they've had good success on the ground, and that's got to please the offensive staff.
Yeah, every offensive coach loves to grind it out on the ground. It wears down a defense and takes time off the clock. The pass is complete. And that'll be enough for the first down. It's now first and 10. They keep it on the ground. And that'll set up a second down.
With the carry.
Zerway in the backfield. Mannix looks to throw on second. Touchdown, Steelers!
Those long TD passes deflate a defense like nothing else.
Number three to attempt the
number three after. For the extra point attempt. Right down the middle, good. Three kicks it off. They'll put it in play at the 20. It's now first and 10. They go with the ground game. And that'll set up a second down. He's one of those guys that can change a game, Ian.
Yeah, Dick, Kendrell Bell just has one of those fast motors. He's quick, tenacious. He can play the pass and the run with equal effectiveness.
Red, 25! Hut!
Hut! Mella pulls it in. And he gets tackled, but makes the first down.
Yeah, that's right, man.
It's now first and 10. They keep it on the ground. Crosses the 35. And he's tackled near the 40. That'll bring up second down.
The defense looked like it was on roller skates on that play, Dick. The O-line just dominated there.
Now that was an attitude play by the offensive line. Great blocking. It's now second and 2. They go with the ground game. 3 yards on the carry.
Great push up front by the big fellas there. They got up under the defenders and drove them out of the hole.
Absolutely, Dan. It looked like the defensive line stood up right at the snap, and the offensive lineman just drove them out of the hole. Tennessee, from their own 42, first down and 10. They keep it on the ground. And he's tackled at the 43. That'll bring up second and long.
Bell smelled the play out right from the snap. Great tackle.
Yeah, there was no fooling him on that play, Dan. He had him from the get-go. Now we have second and 8. McNair looking to throw. He finds his man. And he's tackled after the first down pickup. Now we have first and 10. Comella to the outside. Past the 40. Run good for 1 yard. The Titans with the 7th play of this drive. McNair to throw on second. And the quarterback can't hit his tight end.
Wow, the defender was all over him there. The receiver never had a chance at the ball on that play.
But it's his own fault, Dan. If he ran a better route, he might have been able to shake him. Now we have 3rd and 8. McNair looking downfield. Pulled in by the wideout. Timeout, Titans. Now we have 1st and 10. They go with the ground game. And that'll set up a 2nd down. And there's the 2-minute warning. McNair scans the defense on 2nd down.
Connect. No separation there, Dick. The defender anticipated the route and jumped it. Great coverage.
That's right, Dan. It looked like he expected him to run that route in that situation. Now we have 3rd and 9. McNair drops to throw. Incomplete. That pass intended for the wide receiver.
You know, he might have gotten away with a little inadvertent contact before the ball arrived, but that's good coverage nonetheless.
Hey, if you get caught, it's interference. But if you don't get caught, it's just good coverage, Dan. The kick is up. Tennessee goes away without even a field goal. Maddox to pass on 1st down. Incomplete. The quarterback and wideout can't connect.
The intended receiver.
Maddox back to pass on 2nd.
And the wide receiver drops it, incomplete.
You know, it's almost a must-pass situation here, Ian. They have no choice after throwing those first two incomplete.
Maybe, but they might go with a draw or something to cross the defense up, too.
It's now third and ten.
The pass is caught.
And he was brought down, but he made the first down. Now we have first and ten.
Maddox wants to go long. Pass complete. And he's tackled after a first down pickup. Maddox going to the air. Burris makes the catch. And he gets tackled, but makes the first down.
Number 21.
The receiver simply refused to be denied. Great effort in traffic to make the touchdown catch.
Number three to try the extra point.
Hot, hot.
So the extra point is good. The Steelers gain the lead now as a result of that touchdown. Number three kicks it off. Touchback. They'll start from the 20-yard line.
Come out to the 20-yard line.
Tennessee from their own 20, first down and 10. McNair has time to throw. Mason holds it in.
Anytime you can get that kind of production on first down, offensive football becomes that much easier.
I agree, Dan. The defense is making it way too easy for them on first down.
McNair with good protection. He finds his mark. Now we have first and 10. McNair back to pass. And the wide receiver unable to hang on.
The intended receiver.
McNair in a five receiver set. He'll throw on second. Tries to buy a little time. Wycheck can't bring it in on that sideline pass. It's now third and 10. The intended target down the sidelines.
You can't convert on third down. You're going to have a long day out there.
Yeah, their third down conversion percentage is well below average.
Tennessee lines up in punt formation. It's a perfect snap. The punter gets it off,
pins them inside the 10. Oh, my. Inside the 10, a great punt.
With the punt return.
Kreider trying it outside. And that'll set up a second down. At the intermission, it's the Steelers 17, the Titans 14. Let's take a look at one of the big plays in the first half. What happened on this play, Ian?
This was a big play in the second quarter. What happens here is the receiver gets...
Let's go down to Lonnie Blair.
Thank you, Dick. I spoke with Coach Cower about his team's efforts in the first half. He was happy his team didn't turn the ball over, and he hopes things will continue to go their way in the second half. Back to you guys up in the booth.
And our thanks to Lonnie Blair. What other aspects of the game might they look at, Ian?
If the offense can keep scoring at the same pace, they should have no problem winning this game, Dick.
Now we have first and 10. They keep it on the ground. And he's tackled at the 19. That'll bring up second down. McNair looking for the big yardage. Complete. 25 yards on the pass.
It's Derek Mason.
Here we go.
It's now first and 10.
Hunt.
Wycheck makes the grab. And he's taken down, but after he gets the first. It's now first and 10. McNair back to throw, throws it. Pass is complete, and that completion will get them a first down.
Derek Mason.
McNair looks over the defensive coverage on first down. Touchdown, Titans.
The receiver was standing by himself in the end zone, and the quarterback couldn't help but find him.
Nedney for the point after touchdown. The kick is good.
Point after is good.
Nedney kicks this one off, and the return man starts around the goal line, crosses the 15. 15 yards on the return. Pittsburgh in the I formation, First down and 10. Zero way to the outside, running up the middle. He flies past the first down marker. Could go all the way. 20, 10. Touchdown, Steelers.
The defender responsible for run support was nowhere to be found, and the result is what you would expect, a touchdown.
Number three sets up for the extra point try. And it's good.
The point after is good.
Number three kicks it off. Past the 15, crosses the 20. 37 yards on the return. McNair to throw on first. Mason pulls it in. 23 yards on the play.
Here we go.
It's now first and 10. They go with the ground game. And he manages about six on that run.
That's the way.
Now we have second and three. McNair looking to throw. Soft hands, good completion. Scott wraps him up.
Kenny shows what a rare athlete he is, pulling down the tough catch in some serious traffic.
It's now first and 10. Comella takes the ball. And he's tackled near the 30. That'll bring up second and short.
The fullback is usually kind of the unsung hero of the offense, content to lead block, but they gave him the ball there and he made something happen.
After that run, I really don't know why they don't give it to him more often. It's now second and 6. They keep it on the ground. And that run will set up third and long. And the pass to the wideout calls incomplete.
This offense has struggled to convert on third down all game long. That play was no different.
You're right, Dan. Another fourth down coming up.
The Titans ready themselves for this field goal attempt. The kick is on its way. Tennessee can't put any points on the board.
Is no good.
Right. Pittsburgh from their own 37. First down and 10. Kreider takes the ball on the exchange. And he's finally dragged down near the 45. That'll set up a second down. Maddox fires. Grabbed by the wide receiver. And he's tackled after the first down pickup. Trying it outside. And he's tackled at the 41. That'll bring up second down. Now we have second and 2. Maddox drops to throw. The pass is caught. Mickey tracks him down.
Zeroway bursts off the line, ran a good route, and managed to fight off the defensive back for a big gain there. Great job.
It sure was, Dan. The receiver just refused to be denied. It's now first and 10. We're here in the third quarter. It in. Williams stops him cold.
This defense is going to have to shore up their secondary. They're getting torched on this drive.
They should drop more people in the pass coverage. Maybe some dime and nickel defenses would help.
They go with the ground game. 5 yards on the carry.
Some coaches like to call the red zone the money zone because that is where the big money players, offense or defense, earn their keep. Let's see who earns the money here.
It's now second and 4. They keep it on the ground.
Oh, the coaches love that. They run a little inside run, hoping for a few yards, and the next thing you know, it's 6.
Number 3 to attempt the PAT.
Hot, hot.
He hits the point after. Number 3 kicks it off. Number 19 yards on the return. It's now 1st and 10. They go with the ground game. And he's tackled at the 14. That'll bring up 2nd and long. McNair reads the defense here on 2nd down. He's looking downfield. Porter credited with a sack.
Now that'll take a few hours off the quarterback's life.
Hours? That'll take a few days off his life.
Now we have third and 13.
And he is sacked. Quarterback's eyes got as big as saucers when the defender broke loose. Nowhere to run, nowhere to hide.
Yeah, the defender just enveloped him. No place for the quarterback to go.
Tennessee will kick it away. The snap on target. Punter kicks it. It's a good punt. And the return man starts around the 40. 13 yards on the return.
On the return.
Now we have first and 10.
Keep it on the ground.
And he's tackled near the 20. That'll bring up second and short.
You can't stop me.
Maddox checks the defense on second down. Releases it. And he's unable to hit the back.
Looked like the defender had a little jersey there, but however he did it, he had the receiver's number on that play.
Yeah, whether he held him or not, the receiver couldn't break free.
Hot, hot, hot.
The pass is complete. That completion will get them the first. Maddox looks over the defense on first down.
Hot.
Zerway burrows into the line. Run good for 4 yards.
The offense is obviously thinking about six here, but the defense is looking to hold them to just a field goal.
Pittsburgh with double tight ends. Second and goal.
One more quarter to play. Here we go. It's the Steelers 31, the Titans 21.
Maddox going for it all. Incomplete pass.
If the defense can rise to the challenge, they can hold them to a field goal here. Let's see.
Zerway in the backfield. He wants the ball. Touchdown, Steelers!
Wow, he was churning and burning there, Dick. He broke the line, and the rest was history.
Number three will attempt the extra point. He hits it. Number three kicks this one off. And the return man picks it up around the goal line. He's across the 15. 24 yards on the return. McNair,
it's picked off. The quarterback shoulders the blame there. You can't throw into coverage and expect to come out of it unscathed.
Maddox from the shotgun. They go with the ground game. Past the 25, gain of 3 yards on the play.
With the carry.
Now we have second and 6. Maddox looking downfield. Pass complete. And that'll be enough for a first down. It's now first and 10. The quarterback.
Now that's the type of play that makes a quarterback a little anxious the next time he drops back to pass. Look out for those happy feet next pass play.
And who could blame the quarterback for being a little hesitant next time he drops back? That was a big hit.
It's now second and 11. Maddox going to the air. Incomplete. That pass intended for the wide receiver.
Most defenses like to bring some backers and go straight man-to-man in this part of the field. It'll be interesting to see what they opt to do.
Now we have third and 11. Maddox flushed from the pocket. Touchdown!
The defender did everything right except finish the play. Nice catch for the score.
Number three to attempt the
number three after. For the extra point attempt. So the extra point is good. The Steelers can now breathe easier after that touchdown. Number three kicks it off. And the return man starts around the goal line. Crosses the 15. Past the 20. 22 yards on the return.
With the kick return.
McNair drops back on first down. Wycheck makes the catch. And he was brought down, but he made the first down.
All the way, baby! Work down!
Tennessee from their own 39, first down and 10. They keep it on the ground. And he's tackled near the 40. That'll bring up second down. It's now second and 9. Comella to the outside. He got past the line of scrimmage, but barely. McNair goes to work on third down. He drops to throw. Mason and haul in the perimeter pass.
Great defense on that play, Dick. They had every receiver locked down and the rush was coming.
Yeah, the defense had the entire field blanketed there. Tennessee drops into punt formation. It's a good snap. Punter kicks it away. And the return man starts around the 15. 7 yards on the return. It's now first and 10. Maddox looking to throw. He lets it go. Incomplete, intended for the tight end. To throw, tries to connect, connects on the long ball, and he's tackled after a first down pickup. Zerway takes it straight ahead. And he's tackled near the 45. That'll bring up second and short. It's now second and 4. We're here in the fourth quarter. Maddox back to pass. Out to the flat. Complete. Bullock in on the tackle.
Brenner saved the quarterback's bacon on that play, Dick. He made the catch despite some very good coverage.
Now we have first and 10. Maddox drops to throw. Soft hands, good completion. And he gets tackled, but makes the first down.
They have a timeout to burn. They should use it here to stop the clock.
Yeah, after a long play like that, you want to catch your breath. Gather yourself a little bit.
It's now first and 10. zero way, trying it outside. Loss of two on the play.
By Peter Sherman.
Gotta love it.
Now we have a second and 12. We are here in the fourth quarter. Mannix going to the air. Number 31 picks it off.
I know that wasn't a very good throw, but the receiver's got to help out the quarterback a little bit. Fight for the darn ball.
On the interception return.
Go with the ground game. 4 yards on the carry.
By number 51.
Tennessee from their own 12. Second down, 5 to go. McNair looking downfield. Whitecheck pulls it in. 33 yards on the pass.
Number 89.
Got me a first, baby.
It's now first and 10. They keep it on the ground. And he's tackled near the 50. That'll bring up second down. The pass is complete. And he's tackled near the 50. That'll bring up third and short. McNair lets it fly. Incomplete pass to the wide receiver.
Hendricks to do the punting.
Tennessee in punt formation. It's a perfect snap. The punter gets it off. And the return man starts around the 5. 7 yards on the return.
In a game of field position, you got to move beyond the 30 or 40 before you gain an advantage. We'll see if the offense can get it done.
Now we have first and 10.
Hot, hot. Hot.
Zero way to the outside. Running up the center of the field. And that'll set up a second down.
Ouch, he'll feel that hit tomorrow morning, not to mention the day after that, and the day after that, and, well, you get the point, Dick.
Absolutely. The defender definitely made a lasting impression there. Kreider gets the handoff. And he's tackled at the 18. That'll bring up third down.
By number 23.
Flat 17. Hot, hot. Hot, hot.
Mannix with nothing but time. Incomplete pass.
The intended receiver. Miller to do the punting.
Pittsburgh lines up in punt formation.
Hot.
The snap on target. The punter gets it off. And the return man starts around the 45. 7 yards on the return. McNair reads the defense on first down. He goes back to pass. Mason holds it in. Timeout, Titans.
By number 20.
Releases, and he can't hit the running back.
You know, it's tough to see downfield when you got arms and hands and everything else in your face.
I agree, Danny. He had no clean vision there. He rushed a throw. That was the result.
Now we have second and 10. McNair releases it.
He makes a great throw.
Tennessee with split backs. First down and 10. McNair tries to buy a little time. Wycheck makes the catch near the sideline.
With the reception.
McNair tries to connect. Finney makes the catch.
Oh, a dangerous throw in traffic, but he squeezed it in there somehow. Big play.
Yeah, it was a dangerous toss, but they all look great in the stat sheet. McNair checks out the defensive alignment on first down. He's looking to throw. And the pass to the wideout falls incomplete. McNair back to throw. The touchdown, Titans.
The receiver was either really good or the defender really bad on that play, but the result is the same. Touchdown.
Nedney readies for the point after. He tacks on the extra point. The kicking team needs the ball back. They line up in onside formation. The kick, onside. 3 yards on the return. It's now first and 10. Zerway trying it outside. And that'll set up a second down. The Steelers in the I formation. They're just inside the 40. Maddox looking to throw. Burris makes the grab. 5 yards on the pass.
Burrow.
Pittsburgh in the I formation, third and four.
And that'll wrap it up with the final score, the Steelers 45, the Titans 28.
Titans 28.
Let's take a look at a play that changed the momentum in this game. What happened here on this play, Ian?
On this play, the receiver shows a real knack for finding the end zone. He shakes loose from the defender, finds the ball, and comes down with a score for his team.
With Dan Fouts, this is Dick Enberg saying goodbye now.